Hi, this is a Toyota Previa, and today I'm going to tell you why you definitely should buy one as long as you can. Let's go.
So, welcome to the Toyota Previa. Wait, but where am I? Well, actually, I'm just standing behind this 4.7 meter long gigantic beast. And this is the Toyota Previa, otherwise known as the Toyota otherwise known as the Toyota Estima in Japan, and the Toyota Tarago in Australia. And some small details about this car. This one is equipped with rear-wheel drive and a mid-mounted engine. The engine options were a 2.2 liter diesel, a 2.4 liter four-cylinder petrol engine, and the same 2.4 liter four-cylinder with a supercharger. Now, this one has just a plain up 2.4 liter with the rear-wheel drive. I'm mentioning the rear-wheel drive again because Toyota also had the all-track system, which is an all-wheel drive system for a 90s Toyota minivan. Wait, where have I heard that layout earlier? Mid-engine rear-wheel drive. I think Toyota might have something MR2 in their lineup. Toyota midship runabout 2, 4, 6, 8 seater. So this is practically a Toyota MR2 with 8 seats. Incredible. And it has optional all-wheel drive. It's just insane. So these things were produced from 1990 up until 2000. They stopped in 97 in the United States. But up until 2000, these were still being made. I don't know the exact year of this one, but it means that it's at least 20 years old. And I have to say, for a 20-year-old minivan with 376,000 kilometers, it's holding up pretty freaking well. And that's partly because of the incredible Toyota reliability. But next to this, these vehicles, these Previas or Estimas or Tarragos, were just incredibly solidly built, which made them a bit more expensive than the competition. Here in the Netherlands, where everybody buys cheap ass vehicles, you won't see them that much. But in countries where people do care about their vehicles, for example Switzerland, you will see these driving around occasionally. Not that much anymore because they are pretty old now, but the ones you see still driving around are being loved and are being taken care of by their owners, which is just beautiful. A minivan 20 years old, which people still prefer over newer minivans. So now we move on to the most important part of each minivan, the sliding. So this has only one rear sliding door. Getting into this vehicle, rather easy. You just step in and you're in. It's kind of cramped in here. My head's not touching the roof, which is nice. I have a little grab bar here. I have a little grab bar here. I have a little grab bar here. I have a little grab bar everywhere. Okay. But anyway, there's ample amounts of room. And next to that, there's pretty much nothing. No, really. I'm looking around and I see seat belts. A lap belt for the middle person, the handles you just saw? Oh, it has an ashtray. So it has an ashtray, which is nice. And very important, it has cup holders, which were pretty present in the 90s, but hey, what's gonna do? You have cup holders. Then, stepping out of the front seats and moving into the back, also pretty easy, it's Toyota. You pull this little lever, seat goes forward, and you're in the back. And then you're in the back. Well, there's not much to say about the back. There are more cup holders built into here. There are speakers back here, which the second row doesn't have. Next to that, there's another ashtray. And then there are arm rests, I think. And you have grab handles. So there is also a little handle down here, which moves the whole back seat back. And now, if I go into the front, ta-da! I have leg room. So inventive, Toyota in the 90s. Moving on to the back of the car, I've moved to a different location for the sunlight, and you might hear some engine revving and stuff in the back. That's just a local. Okay, that's just the local youth messing around a bit. Okay, so we open up the back with a bit of help. Okay, just ignore them for a bit. So this is the back of the Toyota Previa. There's ample space. Look, I can just sit down in it, no problem at all. Even bigger dogs and stuff can easily fit in here, but it has a party trick. So I've already dropped the front seat forward, and then we climb inside. No problem at all. You have little loops with which you can drop down the back seats. Then there are little hooks down here which you can pull up and just lift up the whole entire seat, which is just incredibly useful for carrying around big stuff. Okay, so now I'm in the way of myself a bit. Okay, and that's how you create loads and loads of extra space in the back. In order to reverse this, you just reverse the process, which is pretty simple. Unlatching these things, making them go down. Don't lie in the way. Now you go down. Lift this latch up and make it fall into place. Little springs. Seat backs come up. And everything is nice again. Hell yeah. We move to the front. Here on the door panel, there's some fuzzy stuff with a speaker, mirror controls, window controls. Well, window controls. These aren't the window controls, these are door locks. These are the window controls. Yes, this is just very simple. It only has Kirby windows. Kirby windows? What the fuck? Getting into the front is very easy, as you would expect from a car like this. One notable thing to mention is that the handbrake is to the left of you, because the engine has been mounted in the middle. There's pretty much no room for a handbrake there, so they mounted it over here. But as you sit up high, it's not a problem. And as you sit up high, it's not a problem. It's just, well, easily accessible. Then there's one incredibly funny part about this, which is the incredibly 90s gauge cluster, which is just insanely funny. It just looks so incredibly old, and I just really like it. On the blinker stock, there are the lighting controls. On the wiper stock, there are the wiper controls. which is pretty logical if you think about it. Is there anything which is illogical about this car? It has 90s but functioning and normal climate control. It has a normal Kenwood radio. It has ample storage in the back. Ashtrays, of course. A normal gear shifter. A normal glove box. For something which looks as crazy as this does, there's not much abnormal stuff in the interior. The one thing which you could call abnormal is this W shape in the dashboard, which gives you an even bigger and roomier feel than there is already. This Toyota Previa is pretty incredibly normal. It also has a nice sunroof, which you can open if you're strong enough, because the handle has broken off. Come on. Come on. Yeah. Yeah. That was a workout. Next to this, the interior is pretty normal, as it should be in a comfortable 90s minivan.
Okay, but now let's open up the hood. Of course, because of the engine being literally in the middle of the car, this is your hood access. So there's this little flap, and then you come on, flap. And then you have just this little, which you open up to reveal the engine, which is just complete insanity. And here you have ample access to the spark plugs, engine oil, and the dipstick, which is kind of nice. Closing the hood is a little bit more of a hassle as compared to other vehicles, but you know, you have a mid-engined Toyota Previa, which is incredible. And finally, we get to the hood, the real hood this time. So this is just pretty much a maintenance compartment. So up here are pretty much all of the accessories which run the car, like the fan, the battery, and whatever. And in here you have engine oil and stuff. But wait a second. Wait a damn second. There was engine oil under the seat. Why is there another canister for engine oil? That's because this is the secondary engine oil canister. And the nice thing is, there's a lot of backup engine oil in this vehicle. So even if it slowly loses engine oil, which this one pretty much doesn't, it doesn't, oh, it's a Toyota, they don't leak. But even if there's so much extra, you pretty much never have to refill it. This little part alone just speaks so much for Toyota, because they overbuilt literally everything. And that's why these things are still driving on the road to this very day. So lastly, let's talk about design. And in my last review, the Tesla Model 3 review, by the way, if you're hearing more noise, that's not the local youth, that's the local midlife crisis team who have bought gigantic RC cars and they're hooning around. I'm reviewing this at the local hooning place, so maybe search a better spot next time, or maybe not, it's funny. However, talking about design, in my Tesla Model 3 review, I've talked about how I like simple design. This is a great example of what I meant, because this has a line right here, which starts here and goes level, 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 level to the back, continues on,
to the rear bumper, and in the front it continues on with the front bumper. Then there's a smaller line which is barely visible here around the waistline. Then a few centimeters up there's this line which goes along the real waistline, so this is probably more like a belt for a car. If this were painted black, you would know exactly what I mean. But this is the belt, here's the waistline, just simple line all across the car. And then up here, line goes up, goes over, flat, 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 and goes down. In pretty much the same angle, this is a little bit less steep, as in the back. Which actually makes it look very much like an egg, which pretty much everyone calls it. This is the Toyota Previa egg car. Overall, there isn't that much to say about design, because it's so simple, but because of the simplicity, it looks really nice. I find this to be a beautiful car. You might think, but hey, this is not a Lamborghini Aventador, or a Lamborghini Huracan, or a Ferrari Elemento. Elemento is not a Ferrari, Siesto Elemento is Lamborghini. This is what I call understated beauty. People who like normal, who like simple, and who like, well, this is pretty outrageous design, with just the overall shape. And the funny thing is, one shape makes it outrageous, because there's nothing more or less to it than the shape. And that's nice. The things I feel which make this car beautiful is the simple design, the simple long lines, and the one egg shape. So now, let's give this beauty a spin around and drive it. Okay, let's go. So, driving the Toyota Previa. I have to say, this handles way better than you would expect for such a big, long, heavy vehicle. And that's mostly because of this, the engine being right beneath me, which is, I have to say, it's pretty cool. Toyota is just masterful at building vehicles which are there to be preserved. Toyota makes really durable vehicles. Everybody knows this. But this one, really, you don't see many minivans from this era around on the streets. So Toyota is really good at making incredibly durable and long-lasting vehicles. This one being a prime example for it. It came out in the 90s. And this model year ran up until 2000. So it's at least 20 years old, which for a minivan, and 367,000 kilometers is pretty decent. It drives pretty much like new. Well, I don't know how it drove like new, because I wasn't around when it was new, but I imagine it driving with this when it was new. Also, one thing which you don't see anymore in modern day vehicles, literally don't see anymore, is the immense visibility. Really, there are pretty much no dead spots in this vehicle. The windows are so incredibly big. You sit high up, you can see literally everything. If I wanted to, I could see Australia from here. Okay, let's accelerate a bit. It's fast enough. Engine makes 130 kind-ish horsepower, which is enough. This is not a vehicle you choose to be fast in. This is a vehicle you choose to be relaxed in, be driven around by the vehicle itself.
that's how effortless the driving of this thing is. And the nice thing is that because of this great Toyota reliability and the stability which this drivetrain, having the engine mounted in the middle, gives you, you just don't have to worry about it. Really, these vehicles are built like tanks, they behave like tanks, and to drive like tanks, but just a little bit more comfortable. And with that, I think everything has been said about the Toyota Previa, which has to be said. It's very simply an amazing vehicle, and if you can find one in good state, I mean, this one has 370,000 kilometers on the odometer, so it's not about the kilometers or the miles. Oh, but if you find one in good state and you are looking for something like this, really get it. They won't disappoint. Bum, 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 ba, da. But just the idea of driving around in a mid-engine rear-wheel drive minivan, which is practically a Toyota MR2 but with more seats, so we can take the whole gang in it. Just the idea of driving this around is just funny to me. And this is so 90s with the styling outside and interior, and just the whole layout. I love it. It's exactly the nice car which has all the quirks and features you would want in a car, and I love it. It just brings a smile to my face. I can't describe why, but the fact that we live in a reality where something like this, which sounds way too stupid and unrealistic to exist, really does exist, just makes it so funny. So if you have enjoyed this video of me talking about probably one of the greatest minivans to have ever driven around on this small earth, well, go grab yourself a cookie, enjoy your day, because believe me, more is on the way. Have a nice day. Goodbye.
Toyota Previa. What the